Team previews, Minnesota Vikings. A lot to like here. Open 9.5 in Vegas, bet up to 10. Last year, 13-3 straight up. A 12-1 run to end the season. The only loss on the road at Carolina when they had road game, road game, road game. And that was all with Case Keenum. 11-4-1 ATS, 9-7 of the under, plus 5 in the turnovers, tied for 12th. Football Outsiders, the number one defense in the league. They were 6th in offense. They get the big fish in free agency. They acquire Cousins. They also brought in Sheldon Richardson. The quarterbacks are gone, all three of them. Bridgewater, Bradford, and Keenum all gone. McKinnon goes to San Francisco. And the big news, they get Cook back, was essentially a redshirt as he missed 12 games. He got hurt with the injury against Detroit. So they get him back as well. And Murray was able to hold down the fort. It's a lot of weapons here with the Vikings, but I get an upgrade at the quarterback position and I get Cook back. And I agree with the move from 9.5, immediately bet up to 10.
Yeah, I mean, I'm a little bit reluctant to call it an upgrade at the quarterback position.
Oh, my God.
I really am. Listen.
Oh, my Case God.
Hey, you get your take, I'll get my take.
Oh.
I'm a little bit reluctant to call it a major upgrade at the quarterback. Case Keenum played as well as any quarterback in the NFL last year. He did. That coaching staff, no surprise, they coached him up. Kirk Cousins has a history of mediocre play and some fourth quarter comebacks. I'm not convinced that Kirk Cousins is an upgrade over what Minnesota had at the quarterback position last year. I'm really not. Not to say Kirk Cousins is weak. Not to say that the Vikings' brain trust won't be able to design a good game plan for him. But they got elite QB play last year, and they just got rid of every quarterback on the roster. So it's no done deal that a guy who's run one offense for most of his career under Jay Gruden, now learning a different style, is going to be quite as good. Now, obviously, we look at this team on paper, we say, all right, Bradford was hurt last year early on. Dalvin Cook was hurt last year early on. And the fact they went 12-1 down the stretch after those guys got hurt is certainly a testament to what they're capable of doing. They've got 19 starters back. 19 of their 22 starters are returning from a team that made it to the NFC Championship game. You look at two of the starters that are being replaced, and you say, yeah, well, you got Kirk Cousins coming in one, and a former Pro Bowler in Sheldon Richardson coming in for the other, talented free agents that they brought in. The coaching staff is in a situation where there's no flux here. Mike Zimmer is the guy, his fifth season on the job. John DeFilippo, there is a new offense coordinator in John DeFilippo, who was pretty brilliant in Philadelphia last year. But you have George Edwards back on defense as a defense coordinator. There's not a ton of coaching changes for this squad, not a ton of personnel changes for this squad. The biggest issue, Paulie, will the quarterback play be as good this year as it was last year? Any Redskins fan will tell you they've seen Kirk Cousins throw more than his fair share of dicey interceptions with games on the line, something the Vikings quarterbacks did not do at all last year.
That's not true. Keenum was throwing it up for grabs, and he was this close to getting benched. Remember, his own coach wouldn't come out and announce him as the starting quarterback. He had the horrible interception against the Saints in the playoff game and threw one up for grabs against the Redskins on the road, and he was this close to getting benched and had a love affair with Bridgewater for whatever reason. It's, in my opinion, a huge upgrade at the quarterback position because Cousins has never had the weapons that he has to work with now as he has in Minnesota. Thielen last year, 1,200 yards. Diggs, 850 yards. He already has a nice rapport in camp with Rudolph. So he's got a lot of guys to throw to, and the coaching staff was not in love with Keenum last year either, how he would have locked into one wide receiver, and if he wasn't there, he would take off and run. So the coaching staff must love Cousins, who incidentally got 3 years fully guaranteed $84 million. The mainstream stats on defense, fantastic. Passing defense, second. Run defense, second. And they had an all-time great third down defense as well. They had the miracle come from behind win, although they were dominating the first half against the Saints, and they get the miracle touchdown to Diggs, and then were blown out in the NFC title game. I think they're better than Green Bay, and I think they're going to win the division. And my guys in Minnesota, they're close to the team. Some of them are even calling games and work for the team. I understand. Maybe not objective. They think over 10 is stealing when you get Cousins and you get Cook back and you have that great defense and so many weapons to work with that they love the Vikings over 10 and to win that division.
Sure, and this is not a team that lost a whole lot in the offseason. They're really not. When you look at the free agents gone, yeah, they lost all their quarterbacks and all of that. But they re-signed a fair few of their own free agents, Nick Easton, Anthony Harris, Marcus Shirelles, Kai Forbath, et cetera, et cetera. And you certainly have to like what they did in the draft when you're talking about this Vikings team to fill holes. There were concerns about the offensive line. There's still some concerns about the offensive line. They addressed that with the second-round pick, Brian O'Neill, out of Pitt. You know, you can never have too many cornerbacks in the NFL. Mike Hughes at number one. You can never have too many pass rushers in the NFL. Jalen Holmes at number three. And, of course, Tyler Conklin, an interesting guy, at number five. Someone who can catch passes and block fairly well as a sixth, you know, as a red zone guy or something like that. Conklin's a guy who I think has some upside. And I thought it was a steal in the fifth round for Minnesota.
They could use Treadwell getting on the field, too. He's been a big bust. But here's the schedule. The fascinating thing with the NFC, all these elite teams and good teams on paper play one another. And that's a great thing about the NFC. They're two extra. They play the NFC North plays the NFC West and the AFC East. The two extra games at Philly and the Saints at home hammered the Saints to start the season and then beat them in the playoffs. The tough schedule. San Francisco at home. Jimmy G's never lost. They have to go to Lambeau week two. And then they have Buffalo at home. Then they go to the Rams and they go to Philly. Brutal schedule out of the gates for the Vikings. But again, it starts to get a little easier when it's Arizona, the Jets, Detroit, Chicago after that. But all these teams play each other that the NFC is so strong and so many teams that figure to be playoff threats in the conference.
Yeah, which is why the over 10 is not stealing. You know, when you look at this schedule, I understand Minnesota's loaded. I understand the homers are going to love this Viking team. But look at their first three road games, at Green Bay, at LA Rams, at Philly. And they close out at New England, at Seattle later in the season. I mean, yeah, the backstretch. You know, look at them around Thanksgiving. Green Bay, New England, Seattle. I guess a trip to Miami and Detroit and Chicago at the end gives them a chance to make up some ground late. But it's not the type of it's not the Patriots schedule. You know, it's not the schedule for a team that has all of these easy foes. Minnesota's going to be tested this year. I wouldn't be surprised if they do go over 10 wins, but stealing? Not with this schedule. It's not stealing, and especially not. It just depends on how much of a Kirk Cousins believer you are. As for me, I'm dicey on Cousins. I think he's okay. I'm not convinced he's going to be the guy to lead Minnesota to the promised land.
Yep. Well, schedule's different, but they did win 13 games, and I think they're better on paper this year. I also think they're going to go 8-0 at home. That is the loudest stadium right there with Seattle in the league and one of the best home field advantages in the NFL as well. Vikings could go 8-0 at home and then don't have to do much on the road. But it's going to take a little bit of time, maybe a fade early on, to get that offense, get used to that new offense. But once they get humming, watch out with the numbers that Cousins will put up, Thielen and Diggs.
Like the show? Help us keep the lights on. Please make sure to comment, share, and subscribe to all the Sportsbook Review videos. Thanks so much. Best of luck. Enjoy the game.